Tovihu Tobit 10. Now, Tovihu his father counted every day, and when the days of the journey were expired, and they came not, then Tovihu said, "Are they detained? Or is Gavael dead, and there is no man to give him the money?" Therefore he was very sorry. Then his woman said unto him, "My son is dead, seeing he stayed long." And she began to wail him and said, "Now I care for nothing, my son, since I have let you go, the light of my eyes." To whom Tovihu said, "Hold your peace, take no care, for he is safe." But she said, "Hold your peace and deceive me not, my son is dead." And she went out every day into the way which they went, and did eat no meat on the daytime, and ceased not whole nights to bewail her son, Tovihu, until the 14 days of the wedding were expired, which Reuel had sworn that he should spend there. Then Tovihu said to Reuel, "Let me go, for my father and my mother look no more to see me." But his father-in-law said unto him, "Tarry with me, and I will send to your father, and they shall declare unto him how things go with you." But Tovihu said, "No, but let me go to my father." Then Reuel arose and gave him Sarah, his woman, and half his goods, servants and cattle and money. And he blessed them and sent them away, saying, "The Elohim of heaven give you a prosperous journey, my children." And he said to his daughter, "Honor your father and your mother-in-law, which are now your parents, that I may hear good report of you." And he kissed her. Edna also said to Tovihu, "Yahuwah of heaven restore you, my dear brother, and grant that I may see your children of my daughter Sarah before I die, that I may rejoice before Adonai. Behold, I commit my daughter unto you of special trust, where our do not entreat her evil."